guys, my name is Jessie Mew, and welcome back to Taito Ecology. We're back in our rainforest biome today to check up on these little armadillos, and of course, the sleeping ocelot in the background, looking very, very mysterious, hiding under the ferns for a nap, though I have a feeling he chose this location just because these little prey items are in the area. Hopefully he's on the move for some food right now. I have a feeling that's probably the case. Let's see how hungry this guy is. If I can click on the ocelot and not the ferns anyway, because of course he's still hiding in those ferns, just as a cat should when it's creeping around for food, and I'm sure that's what he's doing right now. So this is probably the lowest amount of notifications that we have ever had after an entire month has passed in one of our biomes. So this is actually a very good sign, because that means that we're probably not going to have to worry about too much damage control in this episode, and we can get right into the newer content in the rainforest biome. So I think we're pretty good. Let's see what happened though. It says some mushrooms had problems, which it was probably the agoutis, because we know that the agoutis love to eat those mushrooms. And of course, another group of agoutis has a low population at the moment, but I'm not surprised about that because the ocelots love to eat them. So it seems like we did pretty good. I'm really pleased to see that everything is surviving here. The rainforest biome in particular has been one of the easiest for us to manage, so I guess we're getting better at this. I guess we're getting better at creating a balanced biomes as we go along, so we are definitely learning here. And oh my goodness, look at all of these orchids! I feel like they must have spread a little bit. It's so cool though, they're making like a little arrow of some sort in, in the armadillo's territory. Of course, it seems like both of our armadillos have actually survived. The groups of armadillos, anyway. There's 5 in this group. And let's see how many are over here. There's 7 in that group. Oh my goodness. Can the armadillos or can the ocelots reach them? Yes, they can. Okay. Because, of course, the ocelots have a very big territory, so we don't really need to worry about them not being able to reach any of their food. So I think we're doing pretty good. The ferns seem to have spread a little bit over here as well. And I know there were mushrooms creeping in here. There they are, those lovely mushrooms. Of course. So I don't think the mushrooms actually died off because they seem to reproduce them pretty quickly, replenish themselves anyway as the agoutis eat them. The armadillos are actually insectivores, so even though this guy is slowly marching his way over to this mushroom, he is certainly not going to be munching on that anytime soon. He's going to be looking for these anthills over here, so he can come over and snack on all these tiny little ants. That's kind of cool. They built their little anthill directly in a fern, or maybe the fern grew on top of it. That would probably make a little bit more sense. So let's see. I think what we should probably do is think about unlocking Zone 3 next, because it would probably be a good idea to give this area a little bit more space. Though, now that I'm looking at Zone 2, it looks a little bit sparse, doesn't it? There's not many trees in the area, so I feel like maybe we should come in here and try to find one of those big trees to place in here. Of course, we have, these are the palm trees, I believe, which we placed on Ocelot Island, where ocelots, unfortunately, do not hang around very often because they're always on the move for food. So we'll place some of these palm trees over here as well, because I think it'll spruce the place up a little bit. It'll make it look a little bit more interesting than it does at the moment with all of these little ferns dotting the area. Of course, we have our lovely orchids in here as well, our zebra plants, and oh, what were these called? What were these? The papaya trees, of course. Our lovely papayas all lined up in the back of the biome, so if anything likes to eat fruit, they'll be able to come over there and munch on some lovely papayas. But let's see what else is in here. The pineapple. Maybe something interesting to unlock. The heliconia, the strangler fig, oh gosh, and the kapok tree. Let's try the strangler fig, since it's right next on the list as far as trees go. Let's try unlocking the strangler fig and see how this looks in the biome, because I feel like, being that it's a rainforest, we really need a lot more trees in the area, because of course rainforests are full of all sorts of different plants, including lots of trees, so we really need to work on this, guys. We really need to work on getting all sorts of trees in here. And look at this, this is so cool. Oh my gosh, those crazy designs that the bark makes when it twists around, that is so cool. Oh my goodness, I really like that. So we'll place a couple more of those around. It actually has some fruit on it, quite a bit of fruit, in fact. It's almost halfway full on the little bar there. It does have some leaves too, and I see the kapok tree does not have any sort of coverage for leaves or fruits, so we're going to keep that in mind. I know we ran into a similar situation in the Himalayan mountains, and it turned out that that tree, I believe it was a cedar tree, actually just didn't have anything that was edible on it for our animals, so it was a little bit disappointing. It was just a ornamental tree, something that humans like to use to decorate places, and although it did look very nice, we definitely needed something a little bit more functional at the time. But I think we're doing okay here. Now we have lovely trees all around the area. Way off in the distance, you can see it in the fog, which is really neat. And I think we probably should place a couple more different plants in here too. We'll place some zebra plants over here so we can make this area look a little bit more diverse than it is at the moment. Oh no! Our agoutis have died! Oh no! Well, I kind of expected that, guys. Eventually it had to happen. Those ocelots were actually taking their time with these animals, which is a little bit surprising. It happened in Zone 1, and to be honest, I'm not completely sure where I placed all of the agoutis anymore. I see one over there, one over there. So, something died. Something died in this area, and I do feel like we probably need to replace them just to make sure that our ocelots continue to remain under control here, that they don't go completely off the rails and decide that they're going to destroy everything in the biome. So there's one group of agouti. How many are in this one? Two in that one. Oh my goodness. Only 74 days left until they reproduce. And how about these guys? 100 days for those guys. Okay, so maybe we'll be seeing little baby agoutis in the area pretty soon. That would be pretty cool. I'm sure our ocelots will enjoy that. Little tiny morsels for them to snack on, I have a feeling. And there's our Taito coins too, so that's good. We tend to unlock our Taito coins as soon as we unlock one of the different creatures or trees in the area, so that's always good. We're replenishing our Taito coins very quickly, and this guy's so cute. I love it when they sit on their little rumps when they're eating their food. It's so cute. Of course, Ocelot Island has still been taken over by these crazy agoutis. I really need to start calling it Agouti Island now, because that's all that ever seems to be over here with all of the mushrooms that we've placed. They kind of see this as like the perfect area for them to feast. And you would think that would not be the case, because that is where the ocelots are technically supposed to live. But so far, it's just been agoutis, and they all sleep under the ferns too. I'm not sure if that's actually something that they programmed into the game for them to find the ferns, but I think that is adorable because it looks like they're hiding while they're sleeping. They're staying sheltered in the rainforest, which is probably a very good idea. But right now, I want to go over here and I want to unlock Zone 3. So let's see. Hopefully we have enough Taito coins, right? Yeah, of course we do. Of course. Of course. We actually have quite a few Taito coins from all of the different biomes that we play. I usually rotate between them, which helps us gather Taito coins very, very fast. So we have certainly enough to come over here and start sprucing the place up. Of course, we're going to start with our plants. These lovely ferns. Let's put ferns all over the place on these big hills. This one is very big. Look at this. It's like a big mound of dirt. I wonder what we should put up there. Something special, certainly. That could be another special territory of some sort, just like our Ocelot Island. And of course, the water continues to wrap around all the way around this biome. I believe it ends... Oh! It ends right there, okay. And then the other side of it ends right over here. So there's like a tiny, tiny break right on this mound of dirt here. They couldn't just make it through the dirt, I guess. The hill was too much for the water to erode away. But we'll continue placing ferns over here so there will be enough to spread around in the months ahead. We're also, of course, going to need to place down some pollinators so that can happen. And, of course, I already see one lone mushroom has made it all the way over to the zone. The mushrooms seem to spread very, very fast, which is why I'm not too worried about them. Even though the agouti love to eat mushrooms, I feel like they're not going to disappear anytime soon because they definitely drop in at a very fast rate. so we shouldn't have to worry about those unless our agouti go off the rails when they reproduce, like the deer mice. Oh my goodness, guys, I'm always worried about that, and I see another group has low population already. That's a little bit worrying. Hopefully it's not one of the ones that we just placed in, because that would be very, very disappointing. Actually, I think it's this one right over here. And I think I placed this one in the last time we were in the rainforest biome, so I mean, it's to be expected. Unfortunately, those ocelots just love to eat our little agoutis, so it is to be expected. But let's add some trees over here, these tiny little Amazon flame trees, which are so cute. I love placing those in. I will place more over here too. They also have fruit. They have a little bit of leaves and quite a bit of fruit. So there are a lot of things in this biome that have fruit, which makes me wonder what sort of animals would like to eat the fruit, because there must be something in here in this big long list of animals that absolutely loves fruit. If there's so many options for us to place fruit into the biome, there's even pineapples, just plain old pineapples in here. And those mushrooms again, it's always the mushrooms, guys, it's always the mushrooms, but I'm not too worried about those. So let's unlock the pineapple too, because I think that would be pretty cool to have little pineapples growing in the ground. It looks like there's also some leaves on them that other creatures can eat, which is kind of neat. So we'll just place them around the place in different zones all around here. Some over there right next to our little armadillos, who unfortunately are not going to find them very tasty because there's no insects in those pineapples, hopefully not anyway. Though there are certainly a lot of insects in the area. We have so many ants because the armadillos really love to eat the ants. We discovered that last time we were here too. They ate them up in one giant gulp, which was very surprising. Oh my goodness, look at all of these agoutis. Oh my goodness. This is the group that I just placed in and they have taken over. Oh my gosh, I did not expect there to be that many agouti in that one territory. I kind of forgot that it drops down with 12. Oh my gosh, and they all scattered too. They were over here eating the mushrooms and they were like, nope, you're not gonna look at us. We are gone. They seem to enjoy the orchids too, which is nice. I also enjoy the orchids. They are very, very pretty. Though I'm not sure where those ocelots are. I'm not sure where they wandered off to. Of course, we saw that one at the very beginning, underneath the fern, but of course that ocelot has moved on. They must be around though, they must be alive and well because they are picking away some of our other agoutis, so I'm not too concerned about the ocelots. I'm sure they're doing just fine. Oh, okay, I thought I saw it out of the corner of my eye. Yep, just to prove my point, they are doing just fine. Oh my goodness, and this guy just sleeping next to his dead friend here, and Mr. Ocelot. That is not a good idea. You are a very, very silly agouti. Oh my gosh. That was a little bit disturbing, guys. Oh my goodness. Now he's making a run for it, which is a good thing. You do not want to be stuck around there, Mr. Agouti. But let's go back to zone 3 and continue working at this here. Let's add a couple of those palm trees in the area because I really like these. They are very nice and they will certainly spruce up the place. And then the strangler fig, because these of course are very nice as well. And then we'll take a look at our animals to see if there's anything in particular that we can place into this side of the biome, because I would like to unlock something new for today's episode. So let's see what's in here. There's the cougar, of course, which we unlocked in the grasslands, but I really want to make like an established population of larger prey items before we think about adding in any more large cats, because we know those cats really love to eat, which worries me. We've had so much trouble with the big cats in the past. So let's see, we have the marsh deer. That's actually pretty close on our list. And of course the yellowfoot tortoise, which is so cute. I think we might unlock that the next time we come to this biome, because I think for this one, I would really like to try to make an established group of marsh deer. I think that might be a good idea, because if we have a lot of marsh deer wandering around the area, then we can be pretty confident that if we place down a big cat, they shouldn't completely destroy all of our other populations. I hope so anyway. That's how I'm going to attempt to play it this time. Because usually we just add all of these little morsels around the place and hope that it's enough to stave them off. But it hasn't worked. It really hasn't worked so far. So let's unlock the marsh deer Anna, let's read about them in the bio decks before we place them down. Maybe they like fruit. That would be pretty cool. I hope so. Anyway, there has to be something that likes fruit, right? Marsh deer are herbivores who eat mostly leaves and roots. Okay, so unfortunately not fruit, but maybe they'll like to munch on it every now and then. Who knows? Who knows? And large predators like big cats will prey on marsh deer. Baby deer are particularly vulnerable to predators. Yeah, I expected that. It looks like they have a buff too. This consumer can eat tough life forms, which we like to see. We like to see that. So they'll be able to eat more plants than our typical herbivores. And while many deer have spots when they are babies, marsh deer look like miniature versions of their parents. Their solid-colored reddish coats help them blend in the muddy areas near water sources. Okay, well that's actually good because we have so much water here. So I have a feeling they're really going to enjoy their time in this biome. Let's place one right by the water side because of course they love the water. And how big was their territory? It seemed pretty big. Yeah, it is actually quite big. Okay, so it takes up like a zone and a half, I'm going to say, right? Or maybe two zones? Possibly two. Somewhere in between a zone and a half and two zones. And I think I would also like to place another group over here. So again, we're going to spread out these creatures so they have less of a chance of completely destroying the place if they're munching away at one clustered area. But we do want to make sure that our marsh deer are established before we think about possibly adding in the cougar or the jaguar. The jaguar is way at the end, and we actually spent so many Taito coins in this episode that we don't have enough to even unlock the jaguar. So that's something we're going to have to keep an eye on. And look at these guys. Oh my gosh. I love the color of their coats. Oh my goodness, that was adorable. He got down on his little front legs before he laid down. That was so cute. Oh my gosh. They are adorable, guys. I love those colors. Their coats are so pretty. And the little markings they have right on their foreheads, too. Oh my gosh, I love these guys. They are going to make a great addition to the biome, I think, because they are gorgeous. And I just realized, too, as I saw those moths fluttering in the distance, that we still need to place some moths over here. Some ants, some moths, and of course, some mushrooms, because we have nothing to control the detritus levels in Zone 3 yet. I can't believe I forgot about that. Of course, that's one of the most basic things in this game. We don't want the detritus going out of control as we add different animals into the area. So let's add mushrooms all around here so they can take control of this entire zone. There we go. And you know, the marsh deer might like to munch on the mushrooms sometimes as well, so we want to make sure there's plenty in the area. We'll place some little millipedes on this side of the water because I think they will enjoy that, and some earthworms down here by our tree. There we go, that should be plenty. Oh my goodness, the herd is on the move. They are all running to our strangler fig, aren't they? Is that what wait a second, did they just eat my strangler fig? Did you guys see that? Oh my gosh, it's gone, guys. Oh my gosh. Was that just these two? I think it was three, right? There were three here. Oh my gosh. Did I just make a terrible mistake? Oh my goodness. Okay, rethinking my plans here all of a sudden. Let's place that lovely strangler fig back in the area. Now that they've completely destroyed it. Oh my gosh, what are they doing over here then? If they just swallowed that gigantic tree in one gulp, what are they doing over here? You guys, you better not be destroying all of my trees. Oh my gosh, what are you going to go eat? Let's get off of the menu so we can watch this guy. I'm really curious. Okay, this one is eating the orchids. And not eating them to extinction either. Oh gosh, but then the agoutis came in and they were like, wait a second, that looks pretty good. And the buds are gone. I think they'll grow back though because they're still here in spirit. They're still here. So hopefully they'll be able to grow back before anything else comes by and completely destroys them. Oh my goodness, guys, I didn't even think that that would be an issue. I'm really glad that I didn't cluster these together though, because that would have been even worse if we had two groups of marsh deer right next to each other just gobbling up my trees. Then there would be nothing left by the time I turned around here. But they distracted me for a moment, but I do remember that I have to place some insects in here as well, because we don't want to leave this biome without our insects in the area. So, of course, we need some lovely ants to help control any carcasses that might pop up in the time that we're gone. I'm pretty sure that an ocelot cannot take down a marsh deer. I think that's well beyond their ability, because the marsh deer are large herbivores, and of course the ocelots are very tiny little cats, so I don't think we're going to have to worry about that. But you never know. You never know, and I do want to be prepared just in case something happens and maybe the marsh deer starts starving for some reason if they eat all of my trees. Who knows? So we want to be prepared. We'll place some moths in here too so everything can be pollinated and happy and hopefully can continue spreading all around the biome. And of course our butterflies, because I love those blue butterflies, big blue butterflies. I think that actually covers most of this zone. Of course, the original biomes that the game came with are much smaller than the Himalayas, so it feels so different coming from the Himalayan mountains, which are huge, and then you come back to these smaller areas, and it really does feel a little bit cramped going between the two. But each one is unique, each one is different, and I am really enjoying our time in the rainforest so far. I really love all of these colorful animals. Oh, it's so cute. And all of the different types of trees too. Trees and plants and butterflies and all of this water. That's really interesting as well. Of course, once we finally go visit the desert, I have a feeling we won't be seeing much of this water anywhere, so this is something that we're going to have to enjoy while it lasts. But hopefully our marsh deer will be able to survive the month ahead of them. They don't have any major predators in here at the moment. The only thing they could possibly do is eat themselves to starvation. So hopefully, hopefully we'll be all right. Let's see if any trees disappear as they get up for their breakfast before we end out the episode here. It looks like this guy's going for a lovely fern, not eating too much, and they actually replenished themselves very, very quickly. So I don't think we're going to have to worry about our ferns, but for some reason, those marsh deer just completely destroyed my strangler fig. Oh my gosh. I thought they did it again, but when I clicked on it, it disappeared for a moment. A little ghost fig back there. So I guess we're okay. It doesn't look like they're destroying any more trees at the moment, but they are certainly on the move, and they are certainly taking over all of the plants that are dotting the area. Luckily, oh dear, armadillos. Oh dear, well, I'm sorry, little armadillos, but that's to be expected. But yeah, luckily, Zone 1 is pretty established as far as plants go, so I don't think this group in particular is going to eat themselves to starvation, but I am worried about this one. I'm a little bit worried about this one, so we'll have to see how it goes. But I think that's about it for this episode, so thank you guys so much for watching today, and I will see you all next time. Bye!